Intel finally got news! Quick 5 charges very quickly. Now you can play a game on your PC in the game on the PC. No, in the game on in the PC on your game. This MLM don't go anywhere! Huh? Intel again? After their 10 nanometer desktop CPUs got delayed again and again, Intel finally has something to announce, which is that 10 nanometer CPUs will be delayed again for at least 6 months from its original target date due to defect mode during the manufacturing process. Whoa. Intel wanted to make up for their 10 nanometer delays by pushing the 7 nanometer to launch by the end of 2021, but it looks like it will only happen in 2022 or even much later.
My disappointment is immeasurable.
From what we know right now, the 10 nanometer should be out in 2021 while the 7 nanometer should be out in 2022 or much later. Followed by the news of the delay, Intel's stock price has dropped by 17% while AMD's one has increased by 15%. Rough times, Intel, rough and tough times. With more and more smartphone devices supporting 5G, it is becoming more crucial for smartphone manufacturers to prioritize quick charging capabilities because it is 2020, man. Ain't nobody got time for slow charging. Thank goodness Qualcomm rolled out Quick Charge 5. We can charge... We can charge compatible smartphones by 50% in only 5 minutes. And according to Qualcomm, it is 70% more efficient than its predecessor. While Quick Charge 4 didn't support a lot of smartphones, things will be different for Quick Charge 5, which will be supported on Snapdragon 865, Snapdragon 865 Plus, and future premium Snapdragon mobile platforms like 7 and 8 series. Not only Quick Charge 5 will be 10 degrees Celsius cooler than Quick Charge 4, it will also support wireless charging, 2S batteries and 20 voltage power delivery, as well as USB power delivery and USB Type-C. Although Quick Charge 5 is expected to come out by the third quarter of 2020, just don't be too excited, Yella, okay? Because the technology is based on SMB1396 and SMB1398 chips. So without those chips, your Snapdragon 865 smartphone will not support Quick Charge 5. But don't worry, Yella, I'll wait with you. Do you still own a Game Boy? I had a Game Boy Advance, so I guess you could say that I started gaming at a very young age. If you haven't heard of Analog, it is a company that designs beautiful hardware that supports old games. And they have just recently opened up pre-orders for their latest creation. It is called the Pocket. It sports a 3.5-inch, 665 ppi LCD display made of Gorilla Glass, a 4300 mAh battery with an estimated 6-hour play time. It supports Game Boy, GBC, and GBA games in their original display, and it features a built-in synthesizer. Basically, this means you can play your old Game Boy, Game Boy Advance, and Game Boy Color games in its original display size. The Pocket will launch in May 2021 for only $199.99 USD. Okay, and pre-order opens on August 3rd, which is 2 days later, on their website. So you can head over to their website and place your order if you want. And if you wish to play your old games on your TV, you can purchase an optional dock for $99. What do you think? Now you can take your collection of old Game Boy cartridges off your shelf and play some old games. So many of you want to watch me build a PC. Well, I'm sure I can do that in real life, but I think I need a lot of guidance lah. However, one thing for sure is I can build a PC in Minecraft on my own without any guidance. You heard me, you can now craft your own PC in Minecraft and play Doom. This means you can play a game on your PC in a game on your PC. Modder Delta 2 Force created a mod called VM Computers that enables retro gaming PC in Minecraft. Once you have installed the mod, you can start crafting your own PC. What you're watching now is a gameplay of Doom 1993 on it. Crazy, right? Well, at least now you don't have to worry about your PC not booting. Our daily tasks can be carried out easily by program machine technology, aka AI. However, big players like Jeff Bezos is worried about the potential development of autonomous weapons, which are military systems that can independently target and engage targets based on program description and constraints. For example, Siri, white big bone chick who disses tea.
Target locked on Shane. Missile launching in 3, 2, 1.
Which is why in 2018, Elon Musk, Google's DeepMind founders, and many other individuals have publicly announced to not develop, manufacture, or use killer robots. Malicious AI attacks could include speech synthesis for impersonation, hence the many spam calls, analysis of human behaviors, moods, and beliefs for manipulation, automated hacking, and physical weapons like swarms of micro drones. However, Bezos suggests that we might be overthinking things thanks to mainstream killer robot movies. And we're also not 100% sure what future jobs will be like. Also, scientists are nowhere close to building a general AI with an open-ended utility function that could set its own objectives. What we have now is just narrow AI, meaning this AI can only assist us in carrying out certain tasks, such as self-driving cars. And the idea that AI's first instincts would be to terminate mankind is nothing more than bullshit. So, instead of hurting mankind, Bezos thinks that AI could actually help us in the future. But what do you think? Will AI become something that we cannot live without, like our mobile phones and Wi-Fi? Or killer movies will come true? Let us know in the comment section down below. Guys, if you can, please stay home and stay safe. Public health is everyone's responsibility, and I think it's more important than it. Do your part. Numbers are going up again. I don't wish to enter another MCO because that will only mean that more people will lose their jobs, more companies will go bankrupt, and less content from us. This is MLM, I'm Michelle, and I hope everyone can stay safe. See you in the next one. Bye bye.